G'day and welcome to the Dark Climate. This is one of the most feared snakes on the face of the earth. This is the Black Mamba. We're going to take a look at the deadliest snakes of Africa. Kilimanjaro and the savanna plains of East Africa is the start of our adventure and journey to search for the legendary Black Mamba. The plains are where I'm going to find some of the world's most fearsome reptiles, Africa's deadliest snakes. Have a look at the size of this bloke. He's big and you can see he's dribbling out a bit of urine. He's in muck, which puts him in the potentially aggressive category. He's looking for girl. He's heading out towards the grassy plain as I head up towards the wooded area. Just keep a nice safe distance, but he's going that way, I'm going this way. The big, heavy mammals send out great vibrations through the ground, which is a good warning, early warning for snakes to get out of the way, down holes, under logs, in the tree. They don't want to get stamped into the ground. Cobra. It's a cobra. Well, he's going up, he's going up. Holy hell, he's close. So it doesn't spit. I'm not going to need my glasses. This thing's go. Listen. Come on, mate. Heck, how's this snake? Aggressive or what? Come on, mate. This is the Egyptian cobra. And they're notoriously aggressive, very toxic venom. And I tell you what, this snake is grumpy. Might have something to do with all the game animals. Might have something to do with all the game animals around that have just come past. You know, those big, heavy, hooved animals are really hard on the snakes. And he is grumpy. I can't believe he's gone straight up a tree. I'm gonna see if I can get him out of there. I've never seen a snake more aggressive than this in my life. He flew straight at us, and it's got to have something to do with all the game that's come running past him. Come on, buddy. Oh boy, he means business. Egyptian cobra. Okay. You're all right, mate. You're all right. So the Egyptian cobra has probably got the most widely spread distribution out of all of the cobra species. And therefore, throughout the continent, they claim a lot of victims. They bite readily, and as you can see, these things are just super aggressive. This is the most aggressive animal I've ever come across. Therefore, they're one of the most dangerous, certainly a deadly species. They've killed people. If you don't get anti-venom, Most often you're gonna die, unless it's a very minor bite, which for this species is unlikely. You can see the size of the venom glands on the head. Woohoo! He'd have a lot of venom. A heck of a lot of venom. And the aggression of this snake. They're both nocturnal and diurnal, so they'll hunt day and night. And I don't know why he'd be out right now. You're all right, mate. You're all right, buddy. How's that for aggressive? Now that he's all curled up, his body's curled up there, there's no way I can get anywhere near him. He's a super aggressive snake. Crikey. And big too. Like he'd be around 6 feet. But they get bigger than that. They get up and over 8 feet in length. So they're a large cobra. Really large. Man, this snake is grumpy. Really grumpy. You know, the Egyptian cobra is the species thought to have killed Cleopatra. Isn't that an interesting piece of history? Well, I might just leave this guy on his own. He is so wired, so aggressive. To go up that tree like that, he just wants to get out of the way. Obviously scared of all the big game around here. You're all right, mate. You're all right.
What a sensational snake. And you can understand why they're so hostile. The big herd animals are always very defensive and easily spooked. A snake sharing the same piece of ground as a big animal is only a footstep away from being crushed. It's in here that we're going to find more reptiles, places where the herd animals rarely explore and where any threats will be more predictable.
Twig snake. Woo! Local legend has it, those heads, they can spear straight through your body. It's the venom you got to watch out for. You're all right, mate. Come on now. Come on, mate. This is one snake that I wouldn't want to get tagged by. The twig snake, highly venomous, and there's no anti-venom. They're a colubrid. In Australia, we got colubrids, completely harmless. This is a rear-fanged species, quite common here, and they contribute to a few bites and a few fatalities. They have binocular vision. This species of snake's one of the few, if not the only one in the world, that can locate by sight a non-moving prey item. And so this snake, this species, could actually spot a chameleon in a tree, not moving, and go in on it, whack, hit it. They actually have to chew that prey item to get their venom in because they're rear fangs right at the back of their head. And some people have actually been bitten by them and had no envenomation because they actually have to chew on their victim to envenomate. Have a look at that head, relatively large head for their size, and you can see how he's got that green cap on his head. And that's a really good camouflage technique. It also helps when he's hunting his food, when he's moving through, he'll use that as a leaf mimic. So let's say he's hunting some food, he'll sway like this, mimicking moving leaves. He'll get closer and closer and whack, grab his food source. Another thing that this snake does, let's just see if we can get his forked tongue to come out. He's got an orange tongue with purple colour on the two forks there. You're all right, mate, you're all right. So he'll use that as a lure. He'll drop his tongue down and move it. Bird may see that, come out, whack, strike, chew, kill, and swallow it down whole.
Elephants, a family group, and they're sniffing the air. Even though Steve's downwind, I think they've sensed him, and a herd with calves can be very protective.
Yep, they're onto me, and I don't want them to think I'm a threat, so I'm just gonna curl up in the shade, let them do their thing, and I'll back off.
Steve spotted what looks like another cobra heading away from the elephants into the safety of the undergrowth.
Here it is. Yo! Who's got me?